whether there was an opportunity to have that report on a maybe a quarterly or half yearly basis. So that we could actually have some input into maybe some changes or some input of that sort. And the only other comment I really wanted to make is that, you know, in terms of road safety plan, I was actually mindful of the fact that Merseyside has the seventh greatest overall reduction in police staffing since 2007. You know, so that all has to be taken into consideration. And it's what we're talking about again, the budgets.
Yes, I agree. And that's a fair comment, Anita. And I think it would be noted by the officers, Julie, that if we could have, instead of an annual update, if we could have an update every 6 months to this committee, which would be helpful, I think.
It is actually reported as part of the pledge overview reports as part of the rural plan. The KSI indicator is included on those quarterly reports.
Thank you. Thanks for that. Bruce.
Thank you, Chair. If I can just raise an issue that's covered in the report. Refer to page 33. The second bottom paragraph. It says highways authorities have a statutory duty to take steps to reduce and prevent accidents, promote road safety and secure the safer movement of traffic and pedestrians. I've been asking since last October to have two curb tires dropped in the Morton area for wheelchair access. People in wheelchairs to access the shopping area having to use over the road itself over the pavement, travelling against the flow of traffic. Now, I requested this with the cabinet member. I'm still waiting for a response from him, to be fair. But the officer in charge has told me that there's no budget for this, so I'd like to know, when will there be a budget available? This is critical. It really needs to be sourced. We're not looking at vast amounts of money to put this particular issue to bed and to benefit lots of people, disabled people, wheelchair users. Could somebody possibly tell me when the budget will be available?
What I'll say, Mark,
sorry, Chair.
Can I just say, the budget in my own ward, we put a lot of drop cares in, and it came out of the constituency forum fund. Now that fund this year, again, we keep coming back to this, but the cut,
yeah.
No constituency forum fund. And that's the way we've paid in my ward. But Julie, would you like to come forward, Julie, please? I might get away without calling Mr. Schoolbutton. Yeah, if you could take that up and those two prop cares.
Yeah, thank you, Chair. Members will be aware that the Transport Plan for Growth programme will be going to Cabinet in February for approval. And as part of that process, we're looking into include an element for improved accessibility in local areas, which would incorporate issues like drop curbs. Obviously, it won't be an unlimited pot, and the requests, I'm sure, will exceed what the funding will be available. We will have that provision back within the budget, hopefully, subject to Cabinet approval.
Thank you.
Is that?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking for, basically. Thank you.
Thank you. Could you hold on just a second, Chair, just in case anything else? Is there any other members who would like to raise any issues appertaining to this report?
When if there's a possible money available, that it will be based on road safety. If those money funds is allocated for drop care, it will be based on a road safety issue. So what is the best road safety issue we get the funding for it? Is that the format that we would use?
There'll be a prioritisation process which will have to be developed for that funding. The road safety will form part of that.
Okay. That's great, thank you.
Thanks very much. No more clapping, please. It's been enough. Can I now move on to item 6 of the agenda? Recommendations. Can I ask members to note that report?
Agreed.
Thank you. Item 6, budget proposal workshop. Again, this was an excellent piece of work. Let me just find pages. And this one was very well attended, I'm glad to say. And David's just asked me, the people who attended the workshop, and it was very well attended, I'm glad to say, there were confidential items discussed during this workshop, so if any members have got any questions to ask David tonight appertaining to this report, which is in the supplementary agenda, and I'd like to commend Michael Lester on producing this at such speed for us, and such an excellent report. So please, members, bear in mind the confidentiality that was discussed at the meeting. So having said that...
Can I just say that the confidentiality of the related to the previous conversion, yeah. I don't think we're in there history about parking or paperless things. It was mainly discussed the confidential commercial ones, which are still in progress in respect to the
So everybody who's there is aware of that. Thank you. And are there any questions relating to this report? No. David will try and clarify.
Mr. Chair, page 8 is missed out on.
Page 8 is on the back of page 7.
It's a separate sheet.
Oh,
you'll be seeing that separate
sheet. That's just being missed. My fault.
Sure.
That's wrong. You can't keep passing the job. Any questions? The committee agrees to send these recommendations to Cabinet.
Agreed.
Thank you. The LCR update now, item 7. And David Armstrong is going to answer any questions that anyone might have. We're not having an update tonight, as usual.
Rob's sent her apologies. I'm happy to take the comments.
Any questions? I think the LCR at the moment in the Liverpool City Region Metro Mayor is in the process at the moment of putting his budget together. So it's all eyes on that. But what I will say about the Metro Mayor, I don't know if any members are aware that there's an announcement tonight that the toll on the tunnel is coming down to £1 for fast tag users off peak. Oh, it is coming down. From 7 at night till 7 in the morning. And Sundays. Sundays will be all day free. That's one of the pledges during the election. And the Metro Mayor Steve Rowland is making good on that. So that was an announcement today on Radio Mayor. Any questions for David? No? Thank you. Right, that brings us on to item 8, which is the Liverpool City Region Scrutiny and Overview Committee. We've just finished a piece of work on spatial development. And again, it's a big piece of work, especially about covering the whole of the Merseyside City region, and we're formulating now various recommendations, which at the moment are not in the public domain. But what I'd like to update the committee on, it's a huge piece of work, this. And at the moment, all the local authorities who haven't got local plans are in the process of putting together local plans, which they're going to feed in to the Liverpool City region. And the whole idea is for us all to work together and not be working against one another or in competition with one another. Because Ron was saying before about the transport networks, well, it's the same. We're isolated here, aren't we, on the river, because we're a peninsula. But the other authorities are all interlinked. So you'll have business parks, which Knowsley might want it, and it's on the border with St Helens. And I think it could well start a friction between councils. But what the Metro Mayor is trying to do, and the leaders of all the councils, is work together, and they are working together, to try and nullify and alleviate that. So that's where we're at with the Liverpool City Region. There's another meeting tomorrow. We've been meeting an awful lot, and Jill and I are on the scrutiny committee. There's another meeting tomorrow, and what we'll be looking at next is the air quality throughout the region, and also the effects of universal credit. What we're going to do is split the committee into two, and half of the committee are going to look at air quality, and the other half of the committee are going to look at the impact of universal credit, which this committee is going to be looking at as well in the near future. Just let me finish one, please, and then I'll bring you in. One item, and it's a big item, is where the money's coming from for the capacity of the mayor. Because the government have given us, they've devolved, if you like, 90 million, which is 30 million a year for the next 3 years. But what they haven't done in that sum that they've devolved to local authorities, to the Liverpool City Region rather, is put any capacity in there. So the money's got to come from somewhere for the mayor to have his office. And what I just said, the piece of work we've just done now, for instance, on spatial development, it's such a huge area. There's going to be a need for people in there with expertise. And with that comes salaries. So what we're looking at the moment is where the mayor's going to get his budget from. And the mayor has said, for him to run the office, it's going to take 6.2 million a year. So we've got to decide, as a region, how we're going to fund that. So I would like to bring that to the attention of the committee. But the mayor is at the moment formulating his budget, so we watch this space. So is there any questions on what I just said? Warren, you did indicate.
Just a question really about my keen interest as a civil servant. I don't think I'll be able to effectively scrutinise a government policy given my employment. So I wouldn't know what I'd be able to do in that situation, Chair.
Hang on, we'll just clarify that.
If it's a whole work programme based on a government policy.
Right, you're talking about universal credit?
Yes.
Right. Well, Ron just said that, yes, when we discuss universal credit, you'll have to declare an interest, and then we'll take legal advice whether you do have to leave the room or not. So when we're discussing it, you'll have to declare an interest.
Thank you, Chair.
Okay. Dave?
Two matters. The first one is, how many of the six local authorities come out of the spatial plan?
You mean the local plan?
Yeah, how many? Well,
what we found was St Helens was the only authority with a working local plan, but it was out of date.
Yeah.
Because these things have got to be updated. So all the authorities have been working really hard, including our own. And I think our local plan is just about done, Anita. If I can ask for a comment on that, being chair of the plan.
I don't actually think there's a date for that to be presented, but it will be on the calendar.
And that's and I think all the other local authorities, because it's a statutory duty. The government has said we've all got to have local plans.
I worked on one we had, the original one, many years ago. I understand the whole process and the arguments for and against going forward. The other one was then talking about the Metro Mayor. Would we be looking to get a recommendation from him for a preset like you did from the Police Commissioner?
Well,
given that, since we've got a Metro Mayor, do we need a Police Commissioner?
You throw in the Police Commissioner there today, but we're into party politics then, and
it's the coalition
government.
That's the question.
Please. Warren.
Sorry, sir.
I hope you are. The answer to the Police and Crime Commissioner is, I know our group, the Labour Party, didn't want Police and Crime Commissioners. But again, it was a government decision, rightly or wrongly, you agree or disagree around this table, and the government, and it's the same with the Metro Mayor. Our policy was we didn't want a figurehead, an all-powerful, if you like, but there are checks and balances in there, having said that. As a party, we didn't want it, but it was part of the devolution deal, so we had to go along with that. I was thinking another question in there, Dave.
It was where we see where the preset.
On preset, yes. Well, again,
that's really bad.
Well, again, the government have said the mayor has got the power to impose a preset. But working with the other leaders of the other authorities, it's a very contentious situation. But there's only two ways the mayor can get the funding to fund his office. There's only two ways. One is a preset, and the other one is a levy. And I don't think either of those will be very popular. But these are decisions that have got to be made, yes. So thanks for raising that.
Thank you.
You're quite right.
Thank you quite much.
Anyone else have any questions before we finish on that topic?
No.
No? Thank you. Item 9. Committee work
over.
It's just to be noted, thank you, just to note that before I know. Right, committee work programme, chair to present report. We're doing, as I said before, our next workshop we're going to be looking at universal credit and the ramifications of that, particularly over the Christmas period, where we're looking for bringing the information in now. And we're looking at probably February. We'll be looking, I would think, for two workshops around universal credit. And again, I would urge all the committees to attend. It's another very contentious issue. And I think it's important that we get all the views from all the parties with this issue. So that's the update really on the work programme. Are there any questions? Thank you. And I think everyone can see tonight that there's no any other business, any other urgent business. And the head of legal services has pointed out to me and to other chair, I think, that this shouldn't have been an item on the agenda anyway. There shouldn't be any urgent business. If there's anything appertaining to any of the reports, it should be brought up in the minutes. And if not, it should go on the agenda for our next meeting. Is that okay with everybody? Whether it's okay or not, it's
agreed. Thank you, Chair.
And I'd like to thank everybody for attending tonight. Thank you all. Thank you, Chair.